Welcome to CodeGym. In this video, you'll learn what you'll study on CodeGym, how the course is structured, what you can and should do in order to complete CodeGym, what dark matter is and how to earn and spend it. CodeGym is an online course for those who want to learn how to program and become Java developers. The course consists of four main quests, each focusing on a specific topic. The first quest, Java Syntax, is the simplest. It can be mastered even by someone who has never programmed before. It will teach you about classes, objects, methods, and variables. You'll learn about the basic data types, arrays, conditional operators, loops, briefly cover collections, and solve a lot of tasks. Don't expect fewer tasks in the second quest, Java Core. As you make your way through it, you'll learn the basics of OOP and get acquainted with streams, threads, method overloading, and serialization. The first two quests must be completed in order, but you can study the next two in any order or even simultaneously. The Java multi-threading quest introduces you to multi-threading and gives your practical skills a serious level up. During this quest, you'll complete some cool mini projects. Projects like an online chat, a restaurant automation system, the game 2048, game Arkanoid, and much more. The Java Collections quest is devoted to a detailed study of Java collections. It also covers working with files, archives, and design patterns. There's a lot of practice here too. Now let's take a look at what's inside a quest. Each quest has 10 levels, and each level has 10 to 12 lessons. Each lesson takes no more than 50 minutes to read through. The lessons contain a mix of theory and exercises. You'll earn dark matter for correct task solutions. You can spend it to unlock the next lessons. Now let's go to the lesson list section. This is where you'll find all of the course's lessons. There is a separate card for each lesson. On each card, you'll find a short description of the lesson, its name, and the teacher's avatar. There is also a spot for information about this lesson's quest, level, and number. If the lesson is already unlocked, it will have the available status. If it's not already unlocked, it will have the locked status. There may be times when you'll need to open a specific lesson. There are two ways to do this. First, you can select the desired quest and level using the filters. Second, you can go to the quest map section and find the desired quest's homepage. Then click on a specific level and you'll see that level's lesson list. If you want to quickly return to the last lesson you completed, use one of these two methods. First, cards for the last three lessons you've unlocked are displayed on your profile page under Recent Lessons. Just click any of them and you will be taken straight to the desired lesson. Second, each quest's homepage has a special current lesson icon, which will take you to the last lesson you were working on in this quest. That's all for now. This has been your CodeGym team. Over and out.